Hey, hey, yoga family. Keya Williams here coming at you with a yoga tutorial. So this posture that we are going to work on today is for you. If you regularly practice yoga, you're pretty open in the front of your body and your hamstrings, also in the quadriceps and the hip flexors, and you are looking for a deeper stretch to the backs of your thighs and the fronts of your hips. What pose am I talking about? I'm talking about yogic splits. Now, when I first tried yogic splits, I was kind of perturbed, actually, by the yoga teacher who was instructing us to do this pose because I thought, well, hey, I'm in a yoga class. I'm not in a dance class. I'm not interested in doing any splits. But this is coming from a yoga mama who really doesn't like to stretch. Now, all of my prejudgments aside, one of the reasons that we do these more advanced postures, and yogic splits is a more advanced posture, is so that we can get a deeper benefit in our practice. So if we're already pretty loose and pretty open in the more or less advanced postures of yoga, then we need to progress on to things that are actually going to challenge us and continue to benefit our body. So yogic splits is one of those postures. So if you are a busy mom and you're looking for tutorials like these to help you deepen your asana practice and also are looking to hang out with other yoga mamas that are using yoga as a way to manage their mom life stress, I'll let you know about a free resource that I have available for you at the end of this tutorial. But for now, let's get into our yogic splits practice. We're gonna use a couple of props today, one of which is a block. All right, we only need one of them. And then the other is a blanket or a towel. Now, I'm on a wooden floor, so I'm going to use my blanket as slippage, right? If you're on a carpeted surface or if you have socks on, then you really don't need it. You just need to be able to slide your foot across the surface that you're on. And for me, a blanket's going to do that. All right, let's get into our tutorial.
All right.
Now, because yogic splits are considered a more advanced posture, we're going to make sure that we prepare our body to do it. So one of the ways that we're going to prepare is to stretch out our hip flexors, our quadriceps, and our hamstrings, because those are all areas that we're really going to be getting some intense work in. So a couple of things that I like to do in order to prepare my body for that is to do lunges. So you step one foot forward, and you can do your lunge kind of low here, or maybe lift your chest. The more you lift your chest, the more intense the stretch is going to be in the hip flexor. You can take this lunge high or low, however you want to. Another stretch I like to do, another posture I like to do is just to do a low pyramid pose, flexing the front toes up towards the ceiling and folding over that leg. That kind of helps me stretch out the back of the leg here, which gets a lot of action in yogic splits. And I also want to make sure that my back stays straight when I do this to get the most benefit to it. One last posture I like to do to prepare my body is to do a chest expansion. So just lacing the hands behind you, drawing the knuckles down and lifting your heart, because contrary to popular belief, splits, unless you're folding forward, are actually a back bend. So I want to try to get my chest open and my core engaged enough so that I can lift my sternum and squeeze my shoulder blades together behind me. All right, so once you've warmed your body, maybe you've also done a couple of rounds of sun salutations, or maybe you've taken a walk first before you get into these stretches, I'm going to set up my props. All right, so I have my blanket at the end of my mat. It's off of my mat because I'm on a wooden surface, and that's where my foot's going to go. And I have my block nearby, and I'll show you what I'm going to do with that. So the first thing I'm going to do is take my front leg, whichever I'm choosing right now, and just going to put it on top of my blanket. Now here we go. We're literally going to stretch ourselves out, okay? I'm going to start to walk my back leg back, and I'm going to keep it just like that for now. And then I'm going to flex into my front foot and literally start to send it away from me. Okay? Until it gets straight and I can't bear it anymore. Okay? A little bit uncomfortable, but no pain. All right, so my fingertips are down here to help me. And notice that I'm keeping my back toes curled under. I'm doing that for a reason, because I'm a novice at this posture and I want to make sure that my hips don't splay out. One of the things that you might have learned how to do if you are a dancer or a gymnast is to turn that back leg out and rotate the hip open. That will surely get you lower in your split. However, the alignment is off unless you're a ballet dancer. So I'm going to use my back heel lifted to help me keep my pelvic alignment. Both of my hip bones should be facing forward. Now, if it gets a little tough to hold yourself here, that's where the block comes in. So I'm going to take my block and put it underneath my front thigh. And that's going to provide a bridge for me so that I can bring my hands up. Okay? So once you're pretty sure in your alignment here, you can uncurl those toes, but make sure that all five of your back toenails are pressed down into the floor. Right? Same deal here, lifting the chest, rolling the shoulders back. Okay? Obviously, if you're lower than that, you can draw that front leg in to come out of it. If your split is lower or deeper than that, you don't need the block, but it's kind of an intermediary between getting all the way down and working on it. Alright? So once you come out of that, a good stretch to do is to tuck your toes and come into downward facing dog and do a little wiggle wobble here, especially in that back leg, to allow that hip flexor to really relax back into place. And then when you're done, come on down. Of course, you're going to do that posture on both sides so you don't go walking around in a circle. Alright, so for my yoga mamas out there, if you happen to be a mom who loves getting tips and tricks for your asana practice and also other yogic practices that you can take off of your mat and into your mom life, then join us in the Yoga Mamas Facebook group. We have a community of women from all around the globe, and we are such a supportive place to be to help you in your on-the-mat life and your off-the-mat life. To get access to that group, just go to my website, nourished-motherhood.com/Facebook. Again, that's nourished-motherhood.com/Facebook. Thanks so much for hanging out with me today, and I look forward to seeing you around soon. Take care.